Crash warning. You are warned to be prepared very soon. This is it. As the New World Order's Ionist banksters planned it. Through June 12, 2012. http://betherrightsnews.com/story/2380/693/crash_warning.html. Learn more at atruthsoldier.wordpress.com. jeffnielsen/rockwell.com. Regular readers of my work know that I have been outlining and warning people about two potential economic scenarios as the West's terminally ill economies lurch towards their final collapse. These hollowed out, debt-saturated economies will either crash under the weight of their own insolvency, or our governments will create a hyperinflation death spiral in a last desperate attempt to avoid that bankruptcy event. While both paths represent utter economic suicide, the road to ruin is much different in these two scenarios. This has severely limited the investment options and strategies for any prudent investor. Forced not only to play defense with our investing but to prepare for two more or less opposite events has made precious metals the one asset class which can protect investors from either of these fates. I've explained on multiple occasions in the past why precious metals will outperform other asset classes in both the debt default crash or hyperinflation spiral scenario. The purpose of this piece is not to repeat that analysis, but rather to point out that as of this moment the crash scenario has become not only the most likely scenario, but an imminent event. For those who have been paying attention recently as the West plummets deeper into depression and a global economy teeters, the news that came out today was enough to send shivers down one's spine. On a single day we hear that Europe's interest rates have descended closer to the 0% graveyard already occupied by Japan and the United States. China has slashed its own interest rates again, and that ridiculously inflated, the United States' ISM service sector measurement has reached its lowest level in 2.5 years. Each of these news items has dire implications, and so I'll spend a moment dissecting each of them. As I have detailed in past commentaries, any fiat currency produced at zero cost, that is, with interest rates set at 0%, is worthless as a basic tautology of logic and arithmetic. There can be no possible debate or equivocation here. Just as with the yen and the used, the euro now lurches much closer to the same worthless status. Meanwhile, we see China, the growth engine of the 21st century global economy, again lowering its own interest rates. With China's one-year deposit rate on the renminbi now set at 3%, while the one-year lending rate is now at 6%, China's interest rates are still sane, unlike the West, and its own paper is not, yet, officially worthless. However, China's latest cut in its interest rates signals another deeply disturbing aspect to the economic carnage created by the reckless-slash-greedy-slash-incompetent Western banking cabal. What most other economic commentators still totally fail to grasp is that the terminal economic death spiral in which virtually all Western economies are now trapped bears absolutely no resemblance to any other deflationary collapse in the limited experience of these pseudo-experts. In a normal deflationary episode, by definition the value of the currency in circulation rises. This makes the currency an effective, safe haven. Similarly, in previous deflationary episodes when our economies were still solvent, bonds also represented a safe haven, loaning money to the most reliable debtors, sovereign governments. Neither of these parameters exists today. As Western economies accelerate toward their debt default crash, that is, bonds going to zero, we see inflation raging all around us, that is, currencies going to zero. Official numbers on inflation have become such absurd lies that they are now entirely irrelevant numbers. In the real world, inflation is now a double-digit plague in virtually every economy, and cutting interest rates stokes that inflation still further. Worse, because inflation, by definition, is the destruction of our purchasing power, such crippling inflation causes the collapse of these hollowed-out economies to accelerate. Thus we have a world where inflation and insolvency can end are simultaneously worsening. While Europe and China are stoking the inflationary side of this economic nightmare with their interest rate cuts, simultaneously we get more terrible news out of the world's great economic black hole, the United States economy. While absurd statistical lies have transformed the U.S.'s Greater Depression into an economic recovery, for the past 3 years, the short-term benefits of this propaganda campaign come at a terrible price. Deluded Americans who should have spent the last 3 years bolstering non-existent savings and paying down their extravagant debts have instead done the opposite. They have stopped saving, while once again piling on more debt which they have no hope of servicing over even the medium term. As usual, our greatest condemnation must be reserved for the mainstream media, a corporate propaganda machine which is entirely owned by a handful of oligarchs. To protect the paper empire of the felonious banking cabal, we have been fed an endless diet of "don't single quote worry, be happy" gripe from the shameless shields employed by these oligarchs. News from the United States economy has been totally unequivocal. Once realistic numbers on inflation are used to translate the economic fiction distributed by the United States government, manufacturing has collapsed. The housing sector remains mired in the worst depression in the United States history and saturated with mortgage fraud. There is no prospect of this market healing during our lifetime. Several months of terrible retail sales numbers are being accompanied by a marked sag in the official readings for the United States services sector, with consumption directly or indirectly accounting for well over 80% of the United States economy. Each percentage point drop in the sector of the economy translates almost point for point into a decline in GDP. While the crippled economies of Europe at least attempted suicidal austerity, the United States economy is drowning in such extreme levels of debt that its cowardly two-party dictatorship has refused to even attempt to control the exponential explosion in the United States debt. The United States economy is nothing but a credit card which is past the point of being maxed out. The ludicrous notion that the United States can print its way out of insolvency is nonsense, for, among many, a reason which I've already provided, the United States dollar is already totally worthless. As a basic proposition of arithmetic, worthless paper cannot mitigate insolvency. However, trying to do so is how governments produce hyperinflation. It is the act of attempting to ward off bankruptcy by printing ever larger mountains of worthless paper currency which has always been the catalyst for hyperinflation. As such extreme slash reckless conduct shatters the final delusion of the sheep that this worthless paper actually has value. The analogy of a government which claims it can ward off insolvency with the printing press is a simple one. It is identical to the deadbeat who assures a creditor that he can resolve the problem when one of his bad checks bounces by simply writing another bad check. It doesn't matter if the deadbeat writes one more bad check or a million, none of his debts can be reduced, let alone repaid. So it is with deadbeat governments claiming they can pay their bills by simply printing more and more and more and more paper. It is not a question of if the sheep finally and totally reject all of this fiat paper. The only question which remains is how many months until this occurs. Understand that during the panic of the crash which looms ahead of us, that it is entirely possible that the nominal prices of our precious metals assets, whether bullion or the shares in the miners, could decline still further. This must not deter us, and above all we must not attempt to become traders in this extreme slash insane environment. Those amateur investors who naively believe they can trade in and out of such markets overlook one gigantic variable which can, will, destroy them. As our economies collapse, it is inevitable that both our banking system and markets will be forced to shut down, likely for extended periods. Those who sell their precious metals assets for the bankers' magic beans, that is, fiat paper currencies, risk being caught holding that paper when our banks and markets are closed. By the time the financial system reopens, there is the very real possibility that any slash all paper in their possession will no longer have any value whatsoever. Instead of prospering through their trading, such people can slash will annihilate themselves financially. Understand that what looms ahead of us is an economic cataclysm more severe than anything we have even read about in our history books, let alone experienced in our own lives. Understand what it means to play defense, and do so now, before it's too late. Seats still remain in the financial lifeboats known as gold and silver, but the Titanic is sinking fast and the party is over. reprinted with permission from Silver Gold Bull. July 12, 2012. Rockwell.com/@13/Nielsen1.1.1.html. Jeff Nielsen is Senior Precious Metals Analyst for SilverGoldBull.com. Copyright 2012 Silver Gold Bull. Fair use notice, this post contains copyrighted material the use of which has not always been specifically authorized by the copyright owner. We are making such material available in our efforts to advance understanding of environmental, political, human rights, economic, democracy, scientific, and social justice issues, etc. We believe this constitutes a fair use of any such copyrighted material as provided for in Section 107 of the United States Copyright Law. In accordance with Title 17 U.S., see Section 107, the material on this site is distributed without profit to those who have expressed a prior interest in receiving the included information for research and educational purposes. For more information, go to www.law.cornell.edu/use-code/17/107.shtml.if. If you wish to use copyrighted material from this site for purposes of your own that go beyond fair use, you must obtain permission from the copyright owner.
Okay, I did this text recording of an article. And this is Daniel Towsey speaking. I'm also known as a truth soldier. And please understand that this mess that the world is in, this financial mess, was all done by criminals. Financial criminals. And please understand that the first crime that was committed financially was the creation of the privately owned Federal Reserve of the USA, which has taken this world into a very horrible path of doom and gloom and destruction that has been created by the first corporation in the world, which was the Federal Reserve. So now I sit here for years and years. I've been watching and studying and understanding exactly what has been going on, realizing that all the players involved, nobody tells the truth, ever. People don't care. They only care about, you know, having a nice car in the driveway, their holidays, nice clothing, and all that other crap. But I know that the New World Order is real, and I've seen their plans to destroy the last democracies in the world, which are Canada and the USA. The corporations have divvied up all the assets of the people. They've corporatized all our governments. They're fighting over the resources and destroying this planet in the process. The insanity that's been unleashed on this planet is just endless. There's no end to the insanity that I've learned about and seen and understand. And the few people that realize something is wrong, they try to figure out what's going on. When they start learning how bad all this is, they tend to get pretty scared. Or they just choose to be in denial and think you're just a conspiracy theorist or an idiot or whatever, because no, this can't be possible, nobody's that crazy, all this kind of insanity. No. I look at my television every day and everything looks the same. The media is always telling me, nope, nothing wrong. You know, it's a shame, but corporatism has destroyed this planet. And anything that you get information from that is a corporate source is useless, because corporations have no interest whatsoever in ever telling the truth about anything. And that's the plague that has, you know, the illness that's destroying this planet. The list doesn't end. I've been writing about this for years. And everyone that I know, I've been telling them that very, very soon in North America, we're going to be in a lot of trouble. All our governments are now been taken over. They're now corporations, so they're not our governments anymore. And all the corporations, all they ever do is play with numbers that they create out of thin air. Like the Federal Reserve creates its money out of thin air, and the first corporation mushroomed out to another corporation. Now we've got mega corporations all over the world. And the mega corporations basically think that they're our governments. They have all the wealth, they've stolen everything, they've destroyed every self-sufficient country in the world. In North America, they've pretty well shut down most of our family farms and self-sustainable industries and manufacturing and everything else you can imagine. You look around today, all the young people are lost, they're told to keep going in debt and there's no money. There's no good paying jobs, everything costs too much. Everything is a mess. In my town, you know, a one bedroom is like way beyond the reach of almost everybody that works. Everyone's living on credit. And I told everyone, the credit system, the everything is completely in debt. When this collapse happens, please understand that the worst that I can see is that the cities are bankrupt. The water gets shut off, the power gets shut off, everybody goes crazy. And anyone who's not prepared won't survive even a week. And the warning that I have for you is this, is that the very first thing you're going to need to make sure you have a lot of is water. Because a human can only survive for 3 days without water. So if you're in a place that doesn't have any water, in the first 3 days, a lot of people are going to die. And your body can go, eating very poorly for up to 30 days. So you may not think this is happening, but if you look at the Georgia Guidestones that the lunatics put up in 1980, telling us that they're depopulating the world, and you realize that Zionism was always Nazism, and Nazism has never been destroyed. There's a small group, a cult, called Zionism that was created by Rothschild, and he wrote the protocols of the learned elders of Zion to tell everybody what they're doing to this planet. And then people said, oh, that's a forgery, and they didn't realize that a forgery is always an identical copy of the original. No one ever said that what was written there wasn't real. And anyone ever researched it and looked at it and realized, wow, this has actually been happening, it is happening. So now I put this together here for you to understand that this is your crash warning. There's only a few of you people that even know how to think today. Everyone's been so dumbed down, they haven't got a clue of how to think, what matters, what truth or even means. I've written all this out for everybody for years. A few people are paying attention to what I write, and they're understanding, and they're helping themselves. But I guarantee you that the FEMA camps that have all been up and they're all up and running are not just re-education camps. They're extermination camps, disposal camps. And if you don't believe me, type in FEMA coffins and go see how many they have all over North America and Canada and Europe and all the G countries, the G7 anyway, in Australia. You know, don't ever think it's the messenger that's insane. Don't think that I'm insane for telling you what's going on. You know, all the proof's available. You can go and do your own search for the Georgia Guidestones or type in They Want You Dead as written in stone. You know, learn about the vaccines that are soft kill weapons. Learn about the fluoride, which is an acid that's killing everybody, causing this so-called disease, which is not a disease, it's cancer, which cancer is just an acid eating at you, at your body. And you learn about the chemtrails and that they've been spraying around the planet for more than 20 years. Eventually, you know, if you start looking, you realize that all these big mega corporations are completely insane because they have the power of money on their side and they've had no limit to their insanity. And the way a corporate mind thinks is it doesn't worry about whether or not it should do what it does. It just worries whether or not they can do what they want to do. So years ago, when the Federal Reserve was created, the biggest democracy in the world, which is a functioning, happy democracy at the time, was based on truth. Our world today and for the last 100 years has been undermined by the creation of this sick corporation, and society is no longer functioning on truth. And I've always told people, the white people are probably the stupidest people in the world because they believe all their own lies, and this expression that it's only a little white lie. There's no such thing as a small lie, and there's no such thing. Please understand, okay, here's the secret to thinking. Truth is absolute. That's sanity. And everything has a balance in existence. So the opposite of truth is another absolute. And the further you go from truth, you end up at the other one, which is insanity. And that's absolute. So every time you live your life and you do not seek and speak truth, you are not sane. You have to understand that truth is an action. It only exists when you speak it and act on it. The second you stop acting towards truth, it no longer exists. Truth is not somebody's idea or opinion or fact or anything else. It's a way of thinking. Because you could say something right now to me, which is completely truthful, and a minute later, you could say it again, it would change. That doesn't make you a liar or deceitful or anything else. It just means you're alive, because truth is alive. So, once you understand what truth means, that it's a way of thinking, you'll realize that all your life, if you haven't been seeking truth, by the time you, as you get older and older, you become pretty messed up in the head. And that's how our society is today. It's a complete, huge disaster. Monsanto is destroying all the living life forms in the world. They're cloning human beings, they're cloning plants. There's no limit to what they're not tampering with. They're destroying everything that's natural and beautiful. And people today are having a hard time walking, working, thinking, doing anything because you are what you eat. They can't even find any healthy food in the grocery stores or anywhere else. New World Order shutting down all the what they call organic food sources. And there's another deception. Organic, everything is organic. All food is organic. What you should be seeking is food that is grown from natural seeds and is grown naturally. And that's as close as you can get to being a natural human being. And today the world doesn't really have too many natural human beings. Everybody's too sick physically and mentally and every other way. And the young people I feel sorry for because they have never experienced a society that was functioning based on truth. I watched Iraq be destroyed, and I remember when I was young, Iraq was a beautiful country that everybody in the world wanted to go have vacations at. I watched, you know, I studied about the destruction of the Christian country of Russia, the destruction in of the culture and history of China, the destruction of Japan, the nuking with nuclear bombs of the only two Christian cities in Japan, and the destruction of Laos, Korea, Cambodia, and the list doesn't end. And every time we were told lies by the media that this and that and this and that, and every time you do some research on the internet, you realize, wow, the insane are in charge because they lie about everything. And they continue lying because they don't have to worry about anything because they survive off of money that's produced out of thin air. So you got a little club of insane people that are all insiders into the financial empires of the world. And they're just completely insane. But right now, they're afraid because they're realizing they're losing their power and influence over everyone because everyone's waking up. But this crash coming, as they planned, is going to cause untold suffering the world's never seen. And please understand that the G7 countries are all controlled by these Zionist banksters. They control China, they control Russia, they control Japan, or they tried to control Japan, and they did the Fukushima thing on purpose. There was no earthquake. It was a man-made tsunami that they use nukes to do it with. Anyway, the story is long, and you can learn about that at truthsoldier.wordpress. Just click on the Fukushima, you'll find out what happened there. So, for those of you who have even listened to this article, I can only pray for you, and I can only pray that you know what God is. And I'd like to tell you a little bit about Jesus. Jesus never went to church. Jesus was an activist. Jesus only spoke the truth. And by speaking truth, he was sharing love, because love cannot exist in the absence of truth. Jesus didn't like the bankers, and he was against the bankers. And all Jesus did was walk around and empower people as to the power of truth, or to the power of God, which is what the historians are telling us he was saying. But, you know, Jesus was only trying to tell everyone that if you go towards the light, you go towards the truth, and you go towards that energy, you're going to empower yourself and you'll become stronger. So, if you are not religious, I don't care, because Jesus wasn't religious either. And Jesus never said that he was God. The religions wanted to say that. You know, Jesus only said that he's just a common man, and he never asked us to follow him. He asked us to do as he did, and all he did was go around spreading truth to empower people, to enlighten people, because truth is wisdom, truth is knowledge. So, I've been saying for years that the only thing that's going to save this planet, because if this planet is not guided into the future by truth, then we're all doomed. And for most of us, we're going to be living in a new dark age of 6 feet under. We all have an equal responsibility to live in this world. What we do affects the next person, affects the environment, affects everything. I made it my mission all my life to do no destruction to this planet or to anyone else, to never achieve happiness at the expense of hurting someone else or hurting the environment. So today, very, very soon, probably the internet will be shut down, the power will be turned off. You're going to hear screaming, you're going to hear guns going off. The New World Order really wants to lower the world's population because they think they own the world. They produce this money out of thin air. And when the collapse occurs, by the way, folks, don't think for a second that these financial criminals are going to go broke. Because they're not. Because whatever other currency comes in and pops into place, they're just going to create that currency and continue doing this insanity. Canada, where I live, was actually a functioning democracy. We had no income tax. There was no government that was in debt. And all our governments were common law governments that belonged to the common people. And that's why our parliament in Ottawa, which is the capital city, is called the House of Commons. And everyone had common sense. And I've watched my country, which had its own central bank and still has it but doesn't use it, when the government and a democracy needs something, needs to create something for the people, because the government belongs to the people, the central bank belongs to the people, the money belongs to the people. So when the people need something, they spend the money, which is the government that the people created, spends the money to create whatever it is that the people need, which is hospitals or whatever other infrastructure. And the government doesn't borrow any money because it's like me borrowing money from myself. So the infrastructure is built. The economy is stable. There's no taxes anywhere. You don't need taxes in a democracy. And the corporate state insanity that was created by the British Zionists when they took over the Federal Reserve have corporatized everything. And here in this article up here that you just listened to, it's all about this credit system. And that's the big fraud and the big lie in the whole thing, is that in any functioning society, there's no credit. And that's what Jesus was talking about. He didn't believe in credit because he knew what it meant. It's insanity. So when I hear people talking all these big trillions of dollars and all these numbers, those numbers don't even exist. That money doesn't even exist. It's not in circulation. It's not printed. It's just a number out of someone's mouth or some stupid number that they created in a bank account in a computer. So the problem is not the crash of the economy. The problem is that the whole system is corrupt and doesn't work. And when the Federal Reserve created the Roaring Twenties, for 10 years they spoiled the U.S. people to make thinking they got the highest standard of living in the world, the best country, blah blah blah. And all those people were so damn stupid they thought that they were smarter than everybody else in the world. And while this was going on, the Federal Reserve was going out financing the First World War, the Second World War. I mean, they were financing the First World War even before the bankers were doing that, even before the Federal Reserve. If you look at Rothschild, when he owned and created Napoleon Bonaparte's army that went around destroying peaceful countries to steal their countries, the resources, and to indebt them to the bankers. And then Rothschild had 5 kids, and he put all his kids in charge of all the banks of all the countries that he conquered and destroyed. Well, that agenda and that system has been working very well ever since. And the people of today haven't been given an education of any kind about any real history, about anything. And I'm one of the few people that is explaining all this so that people can understand what has brought us to this point. They've tried to kill me many times and left me pretty crippled up, and I live a pretty miserable life now, getting around in a wheelchair. But I've told everyone, I will never be insane. I will never lower my standards, even if it means my life. But all those other people out there that I see all around me don't have a clue why the skies are no longer blue. And you know, you get jets flying all day long over uninhabited areas, you know, just everywhere in the world, just turning the sky white. The problem is that the insanity is huge. It's out of control. It's in every aspect of life. That insanity that was unleashed by the Federal Reserve and the creation of money out of thin air has given the wealth to all the insane so they can do all their insanity. And the insane don't abide by any laws of nature or any laws of society, because they just alter and manipulate your perception of reality. They change the school curriculum, they change all the crap on television and everything else, and they just brainwash everyone. And that whole system is just all collapsing now. But the insane don't care. They figure, well, we've got the wealth, we've got all the night, we've got the islands, we live all the safe places, and when everyone dies, we're going to end up with a wilderness that we can just, you know, have wildlife there. Well, that's not true either. The chemtrails is probably going to do a pretty good job of messing up this planet. The GMO, genetically modified organisms that Monsanto is unleashing everywhere. They're unleashing mosquitoes all over the environment. They're unleashing all kinds of cloned artificial life all over the world, in the oceans. And then you got all the radiation coming from all the nuclear plants in the world in Fukushima. And nuclear energy was insanity because these people created these nuclear power plants that produced radioactive waste that could never be disposed of. And all these plants are getting old. The profit's running out of them. And they've all got these huge time bombs of waste, nuclear waste, sitting on their properties. What is it going to take? Another 5, 10 years, 15? Doesn't really matter how many years it's going to take, but every one of those plants is going to shut down because the money is going to run out to fix them. And who's going to take care and who's going to pay to keep all the systems running forever and ever to keep all those spent fuel rods from blowing up? People, that's how bad the situation is, and it's much worse. Everywhere in our society and everything I've looked at, whenever I've spoken the truth, people thought I was like an alien. Truth today is like you're insane to speak truth. I've had people say to me, it's not possible for people not to lie. And I told them, that's not true, I never lie. And they say, well, that's not possible either. I said, of course it is, because truth is an action. I have self-control, so I choose not to be a liar. I don't lie to myself, and I don't lie to anyone else. And I'm as close to nature as I can be. So, if you think that your little lies didn't matter, they do matter. And the real problem in the world is the pyramid scheme. And this pyramid scheme started even before Egypt, way back in Roman times. So, we have to change our society where we don't have anyone at the top. We have to live in balance with nature, but that's not going to be possible because nature has been destroyed so much. There's almost no wildlife left anywhere in the world, and what's left isn't very healthy. Now we've got the depleted uranium and the plutonium and all the other radiations going all over the world that's altering all the DNA of all living life forms. You know, we have a small little window of opportunity to wake up and smarten up and speak the truth for a change in your life. And start a worldwide truth revolution. Because truth is the only thing that's going to save us. You need to plant seeds of truth in everyone you meet, into their minds, even if it's only a little tiny seed. Because when the seeds of truth are sown, the grassroots truth revolution will blossom from the enlightenment. And this is Daniel Towsey speaking. And for all of you who know me, great. For all of you who think I'm a lunatic and I'm insane, shame on you. And for you criminals in the military and in the police that have done me so much harm in my life, and all the people in the government that in authority that's done me a lot of harm, it's too bad you can't look in a mirror at your soul. And you think I'm screwed up, and you think I'm delusional, and you think I'm insane? Right. Well, time's running out for everybody because this crash has been planned and it's deliberate, and they're planning on killing a lot of people. And right now you've got the Americans bringing pretty well all their military over to the Middle East, four aircraft carriers and everything else, and China and Russia's in there, and they're going to start a third world war. The war started a long time ago. It's a corporate war, all these big mega corporations fighting each other. So I'm not sure, but I would say that this third world war plan they have is going to be their way of just taking care of all the financial problems. If they got no money to feed the people, it means we'll just kill them all. But their insanity is just going to continue destroying this planet. Because every war they've ever had just destroys the environment and the natural world forever. And the Americans and most of the G countries use depleted uranium in all their munitions, so they're unleashing radiation all over the planet every time they fire a bomb or a bullet or whatever else. Welcome to the New World Order. There is no order. All there is chaos and insanity. thanks to Mr. Rothschild, Rockefeller, and all the other criminals and assholes that did 9/11 and all, just doing the rest of the harm to the world. You may kill me, but you are all pieces of shit. And for the good people in this world, I love you. Do your best, because there's lots of good people in the world. Don't think you're alone. You're not. God be with all of us.